Hello viewers, welcome to the lecture series on financial accounting. Today in this lecture, we shall cover the topic self-balancing and sectional balancing. In our previous lecture, we have learned in detail how to prepare sales ledger and purchase ledger under self-balancing. Today, we shall discuss to prepare the ledger accounts, that is general ledger account, and then we will prepare miscellaneous accounts under it. As we know that self-balancing is the type of ledgers where each sort of ledgers are completing itself. That is, for sales ledger, a trial balance is prepared, for purchase ledger, a trial balance is prepared, and for general ledger, we shall prepare a trial balance. One aspect is being completed by the ledger account, sales ledgers and purchase ledger, and to complete the other aspect, we take the help of general ledger adjustment in purchase ledger and general ledger adjustment in sales ledger. When we prepare the general ledger, we shall prepare two helping accounts or additional accounts, and they are known as sales ledger adjustment and purchase ledger adjustment. So, we shall start up with a practical example.
Ma'am, how to prepare general ledger under self-balancing?
We shall take up the same practical example as we have discussed to prepare sales ledger and purchase ledger, and shall start making the accounts under general ledger. So, see this practical question. Here the details of debtors and the transactions which we have entered into with the debtors are being given. There are three debtors and A, B and C, and credit sale has been made in aggregate 13,000 to them. We have received cash against such credit sales from them rupees 5,000, and adjusting figures regarding each and every debtor has been given in the table. We have also allowed them discount while making the payments, that is, as in when cash has been received from them, discount is given to them, and it amounts to 500 in total, while the individual figures are also being given in the table. Similarly, the information regarding creditors are also being given in the question. It is the same question which we have used while preparing sales ledger and purchase ledger. Here creditors are X, Y and Z. Credit purchases in aggregate amounts to 7000, while cash paid is 2500 and the discount received is 250. And adjacent to all, the individual figures of credit purchases, cash paid and discount received is being given. So, we shall first of all prepare the general ledger. We will take the sales account. So, sales amounts to 13,000. It has come as, by A, we have given the entry 5,000, by B, 4,000, and by C, 4,000. So, in all, it amounts to 13,000. This entry is A's account debit to sales. Since it is a credit sales, so rather than cash, A's account is being used. So, in this way, the sales account under general ledger is being prepared and it will show a credit balance. Now, the purchases account has to be considered. So, first of all, on the debit side of purchase account, we shall pass the entry. Since the general entry for the credit purchases is purchases account debit to creditors, and our creditors are X, Y and Z. So, purchases account on its debit side, we shall write to X 4000, to Y 2000 and to Z 1000. In aggregate, it shall amount to 7000, which shall be the balance of purchases account. Now, we need to prepare the cash account. As we have received cash from debtors, so on the debit side of the cash account, we are going to pass the entries, or we are going to write down the details of debtors. That is, from A, we have received 1000, from B, 2000 and to C, 2000. In aggregate, we have received cash from all the three debtors rupees 5000. Now, we have also made payments to the creditors for the credit purchases we have made. So, on the credit side of the cash account, names of the creditors would appear on the credit side as, by X 1000, by Y 1000 and by Z 500. So, the balancing have to be done for this balance. For the balancing has to be done for this account. On the debit side, we have 5000, while on the credit side, it amounts to 2500. So the balancing figure of 2500 would be shown as the debit balance of cash account. Now we are going to prepare the discount allowed. Discount allows general entries, discount account debit to debtors. Since we have allowed discount to each of the debtors, that is A, B and C. So let's see how we will record this in the discount account. To A, we shall write on the debit side 100, to B 200 and to C 200. In all, the discount allowed is 500 and it will show the debit balance of 500. So we will write on the credit side by balance carried down. In the subsequent year, as we know that to balance carried down shall become to balance brought down, and we will do the further accounting. Now we will make another account and it is known as discount received. Discount receipts entry would be recorded on the credit side because discount received is from the creditors. So its entry would be creditors account debit to discount received. So it will be recorded on the credit side. First of all, we will write by X rupees 100, by Y rupees 100 and by Z 50. So its aggregate is 250. Now we will do the balancing and it shall amount to 250 as the credit balance of discount received. Now there is a additional account which we are going to prepare in the general ledger. As we have discussed already that in order to complete the double entry aspect of the accounts, we have to take the help of sales ledger adjustment account in the general ledger. Since only one-sided entries are being recorded in the for the transaction, so this account is going to be the supplementary account to complete our double entries. Now we will prepare the additional account to complete the double entry aspect under general ledger. So we will open the account sales ledger adjustment account, and on the debit side, first of all we will pass the entry to general ledger adjustment and it is for credit sales. Here we are going to write the aggregate amount of credit sales. See how this entry of 13,000 has come. While passing the general entries, at the time of credit sales, we have passed the entry debtors to sales amounting to 30,000 with each individual debtor, and at the period end, since self-balancing is done at period end, it can be weekly, monthly, depending upon the policy so framed by the management. So we have passed this entry as sales ledger adjustment account debit in general ledger to general ledger adjustment. Since we are preparing the general ledgers and we have opened the sales ledger adjustment account over there, so to general ledger shall appear over here, to general ledger adjustment for credit sales, and it has flown from here, that is from credit side we have taken the figure. Now the next one is on the credit side. Sales ledger adjustments credit side is showing by general ledger adjustment account, and first entry is in relation to cash. So this cash of 5000 has to be recorded. What is this? This was the cash received from debtors. So we have passed this entry at the time of cash received as cash account debit to the individual debtors, and at the period end this entry was passed into the general ledger as general ledger adjustment account debit to sales ledger adjustment 5000, and this same entry is being shown on the credit side. It's a simple posting of the journal entry, so made in the journal this entry has been posted properly over there and it is in relation to cash so received. Now the next entry is of discount. This is the discount allowed to the customers or debtors. So let's see how this entry was drafted. In our journal, we have passed the discount allowed when we have given this discount to the debtors as discount account debit to debtors, and respective debtors account has been credited, and at the period end we will pass this entry as general ledger adjustment account debit to sales ledger adjustment of 500, and this very entry is being posted in the sales ledger adjustment on the credit side because sales ledger is credit over here. So on the credit side of this account, by general ledger adjustment of rupees 500 has come. Now this balance will be 13,000 is the debit side's total, and 5500 is the credit size total. So, the balancing figure of sales ledger adjustment amounts to rupees 7500. So, this balancing will be done and sales ledger adjustment account will show a debit balance. Similarly, we are going to prepare the purchase ledger adjustment account, where we have to pass these entries, and on the credit side, this credit purchase is 7000 would appear, then whatever cash has been paid and discount we have received, we will show it on the debit side, and the balancing figure, that is 7000 minus 2500 and 250, will give us the figure of 4250. So, the purchase ledger adjustment account will show the credit balance.
Ma'am, how shall we prepare trial balance under general ledger?
Trial balance under general ledger will be prepared by taking the balances of all the accounts we have made so far. The debit balances of the accounts will appear on the debit side of the trial balance, and the credit balance shall appear on the credit side of trial balance. The method of preparation of trial balance will be same as in the normal accounting scenario we prepare. So, under self-balancing system, in the general ledger, trial balance shall be prepared accordingly. So, let's see how the information shall flow on the debit and credit side of trial balance. So, this is our trial balance. Here, first of all, we will take sales account, and its balance is coming on the credit side, that is 13,000. This 13,000 has come from this account. It's showing the credit balance. So, on the credit side, we have taken 13,000. So, this is the way this balancing has been done. The purpose behind doing the balancing was to write down the proper credit balance on the proper side of trial balance. Now, the next one is purchases account. It is showing the debit balance of 7,000. Let's see how the balance has come. It is the debit balance on the purchases account, and it amounts to 7,000. That's what we have seen in the trial balance. Now, the next item on the trial balance is cash account. It is 2500. It is also appearing on the debit side, because while preparing the cash account, we have done the balancing of cash account, that is of cash received and cash paid. So, 5000 minus 2500, that is 2500 was the debit balance, and so it was appearing on the debit side of trial balance. Now, let's see the next item on the trial balance of general ledger. It is discount allowed, and it is the debit balance of this account called discount allowed. It has come as 500. So, we have written on the debit side of the trial balance rupees 500. Next item is discount received. Discount received is an income. So, under credit amount or the credit column of trial balance, we will show the credit amount of rupees 250 of the discount so received, and it has come this way, this from the discount received ledger. Next one is sales ledger adjustment. Here we are depicting the debit balance of sales ledger adjustment account we have so prepared for passing the entries at the period end. Now, the next one is purchase ledger adjustment account, and it is the credit balance of the purchase ledger adjustment account which we have prepared for passing the credit purchase entries and the cash paid and discount received entries in the purchase ledger adjustment. So, this balancing figure was appearing in our trial balance. So, when we do the balancing, our trial balance will match up. So, 70,500 will be the amount column of the debit column as well as credit column of the trial balance. In this way, we have learned how to prepare the ledger accounts under self-balancing. We have used multiple accounts, that is sales ledger account, purchase ledger account and general ledger account, and for each set of account a trial balance was prepared. As the name of this method of accounting is self-balancing, each set of ledger is self-balanced in itself. The basic requirement of preparing self-balancing accounting is that multiple transactions can be traced easily. If there is any error, we can trace out the errors easily. division of labor can be done. Many hands can get the work. Individual people or the specific person can be authorized to prepare a particular set of account. So, let's see the advantages of self-balancing. First of all, localize errors and facilitates quick detection. That means errors can be detected fast, they can be corrected fast, there can be division of work, as I have already discussed, that person A can be assigned the work of sales ledger preparation, person B can be assigned the work of preparation of purchase ledger, and another person can be provided the work to prepare the general ledgers. It improves the efficiency of workers by deterring carelessness of the workers, as there are control checks among each other. Then chances of fraud can be minimized using self-balancing system.
Ma'am, what is sectional balancing?
Sectional balancing is one of the forms of maintaining the multiple ledger accounts. But how does it differs from self-balancing, we shall learn in detail. So, first of all, let us read the academic definition of self-balancing. The system of multiple ledgers designed to make the main ledger complete is called sectional balancing system, meaning thereby that only one set of accounts will be complete. Sales ledger and purchase ledger would not be the complete entries, that is double entry aspect would only be completed in the main ledger, and which is known as general ledger. The name is obvious because it balances a section of the total ledger system comprising of general or main ledger, debtors and creditors ledger. Hence, the end product of application of sectional balancing system is a balanced main ledger, which is known as general ledger, and unbalanced debtor and creditors balance. So, here only one trial balance will be prepared, and that is for the general ledger. Now, a question comes in mind, that how does sectional balancing differs from self-balancing? Sectional balancing differs from self-balancing because in sectional balancing, only a section of the groups of ledger is self-balanced. And correctness of the posting of sales and purchase ledgers can be verified by preparing total debtors and total creditors account in general ledger. Meaning thereby that in sales ledger, individual debtors account will be prepared, then we will take their balances. We will make a summary of those balances, that is from A, a certain amount is due, then from B and then C. Then those amounts will be added up. We will then tally those amount with the total data so prepared in the general ledger. So, whatever balance of total debtors is coming, it shall be equal to the aggregate of the balances of the debtors as we have prepared in the sales ledger. Similarly, total creditors would be matched up accordingly. Now, under sectional balancing system, a trial balance is prepared only for general ledger, whereas in self-balancing system, a trial balance is prepared for each one of the ledgers independently. As we have seen in the self-balancing system, that we had three trial balances, one for sales ledger, one for purchase ledger and one for the general ledger. Here only one trial balance will be prepared. Let us come to the features of sectional balancing. As we have discussed the scheme of sectional balancing, that there will be just one trial balance, that is of general ledger, while there will be no trial balance of total debtors and creditors. Reason is that debtors ledger contains only personal account of each of the trade debtors of the firm, and creditors ledger contain each of the personal account of trade creditors. So, the second aspect of the expenses, that is of real accounts or the nominal accounts, would be missing over there. For example, cash has been received from Mr. A. So, A's account when we prepare, we can write whatever cash has been received, that is by cash, but cash account is not open over there. It will be open in general ledger. The general ledger contains all accounts such as real, personal, nominal, except those of the trade debtors and trade creditors. However, it contains total debtors and creditors. total creditors account, meaning thereby that cash account will be prepared, sales accounts will be prepared, purchase account will be prepared, but instead of preparing the individual debtors and creditors account, we shall prepare only one account, that is known as total debtor and total creditor, while their balances would be matched up with the schedules of the debtors which we have extracted from debtors ledger. So, this is the basic scheme or the mechanism of preparing sectional balancing. With this, we are ending up our lecture of today. In today's lecture, we have learned in detail the mechanism of preparation of general ledger under self-balancing, and we have learned to draft the trial balance. We have also learned in detail the mechanism of sectional balancing system, and we have learned in detail the difference between the two systems of accounting, that is how the accounts are being prepared under self-balancing system and what are the features and mechanism of preparation of accounts under sectional balancing system. With this, we are ending up our lecture of today. Thank you.